a lot of pretty girls that I've hooked up with, though, have, yeah, there's been something.
What do you mean?
Just like pussy stinks or something.
Really?
Something, yeah.
All you get's bruised fruit?
Any girl that I would say, any girl that I would say is like, I was like, holy shit, I can't believe this girl's fucking me. She's so beautiful. There's always some point where you're like, oh yeah. By the way,
not shark teeth.
By the way, the problem might be honestly like problem drunk.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean.
Like, I like to hide it up with a bunch of emotional issues, and then that way I can find out about it as I reveal myself to them.
Yeah,
and then I see it,
and then it unfolds.
Oh my God, I'm in trouble. I'm in a trap.
Corey, you having fun shooting the show today? I know this isn't your favorite thing, the film, but I appreciate you being here. Does rumor have it that, Corey, you can hop on the microphone too, if you don't mind, that you were involved, you were a camera guy on a porn shoot before?
Well, I did the lighting, and I didn't know it was a porn for the first maybe 4 hours I was there.
Really?
You thought it was really indie?
I thought it was really indie. I got a call, this guy, his name was Danny. Like, it's Fox with two X's.
Yeah, that should have been the first clue.
So that wasn't the clue.
There was so many.
He goes, hey, what's up? My name's Johnny Lodes. I need you to
with a Z?
Yeah, with the Z's, definitely at the Z at the end.
There were probably 15 clues along the way that I should have figured out what was going on. And I was like, when's the job? He was like, when can you be here? And like, I went to this place in Midtown, and I was like, is there a script? Like, how am I lighting this up? And he was like, nah, man, it's just a scene, you know, they're going to be here. It's like in an office, you know, there's the boss, and she's asking for more time off work. And I was like, that sounds like a really stupid movie that we're working on.
Who did you get write this?
So I'm lighting it, and I still need like half an hour to do it. And he's like, nah, it's good enough. Bring him in. And like,
is his personality just like this too?
Yeah,
that's fine.
It sounds like everything.
Pacino.
It's
Mrs. Streep.
It sounds like everything he's saying. He's running his fingers through his chest hair. How long do you need me to let? He goes 30 minutes, but we could probably do it in 15. What's going on in here? Sentences like "bring him in," "bring him in."
They brought him in. What they look like?
Well, it was two women, and they were both wearing, I felt, inappropriate shirts for a workplace environment.
That's there you fair. Go. Come on. I mean,
there was a lot of cleavage. Well, I thought maybe it's
you're
Friday.
You're a very conservative man.
Yeah.
That's so funny. So when they bring in these two women, are you still unaware it's a porn?
I still didn't know. And they start running the lines, and I'm like, the dialogue's horrible.
She goes, I'm just looking for something to fill up my time. And Corey's lighting going, who the fuck wrote this?
I got something that can fill you with something.
He goes, yeah, all right. And right now, Mr. Fox, at this point, is this where I fuck her brains out on the desk? And Corey's like, man, these guys, this is going to be a shitty movie.
Yeah. You know what? Don't even put me in the credits.
Yeah.
I don't care that I was
here. The two girls come in and they start running the lines. Do you remember any of the dialogue?
I just remember when the director said, take your shirt off. And then these girls were like 69ing maybe 15 seconds later.
Oh, what?
And I turned to the guy standing next to me. I was like, is this a porn? He was like, the fuck are you talking about? Of course.
Yeah.
Also, he just said to take your shirts off, and they took some artistic liberty by 69ing. Yeah. Wow, I guess he's letting them improv, and they'll get it in post.
You can't teach love of the game. As these girls get in there, they know, just they're like magnets.
Were they hot? Were they hot chicks? What kind of level of porn is this?
Yeah, well, I mean, it was the kind of level porn where they're hiring people to work on it about an hour before they started filming.
There you go. Dude, you got to watch the whole thing, though?
Yeah.
Did you bone up?
They tried to put me in like a behind-the-scenes video.
Did your dick sucked or something?
No.
They didn't offer that? They're just going to have you light a place and not offer your dick sucked.
Dude, Jay, you seem like the kind of guy that would get into lighting just so you could work on a porn set.
I'm going to become an interrogator because Corey's hiding something. You can tell the way he's holding back. Look,
Jacob's
at Jacob.
Nodding.
Yeah.
Jacob's a good second cop to you.
What happened? Who sucked your dick on that set? Yeah. Mr. Fox himself?
He goes, Corey, I want to thank you in a way that money seems not personal enough.
Don't look at it as a man. Look at it as a stranger's mouth.
Corey, what are we getting tripped up about? You did an excellent job lighting it. I'm Danny Fox. I like to suck off my lighting.
And I like you.
I woke up on a Thursday and I said, I'm going to taste the lighting man's cum. Let's make it happen.
What happened, Corey?
None of that stuff, but yeah, I wish that it had.
No, wait, something happened. Yeah,
something happened, dude. I see what Jay's talking about. You're squirrely as shit, dude.
I know what it's like to be Jacob now. I'm like,
yeah. Well, I just want to say this. I was doing good cop, bad cop, but now
he's got something.
I see him. I see him.
They suck your dick off camera.
Jay should fight. If you were a police officer, yeah, you would have so many closed cases. This court go like this. He goes,
yeah, discombobulated. Yeah, that was right. No, goes, right away, Corey was about to ask. Corey's about to go, can I have some water?
He goes, hey, buddy, you want me to get you that Dr. Pepper and those flaming Cheetos now? Your first 48. First 48.
You, they both suck your dick afterwards. Both girls?
I don't remember.
This is before you were engaged in all that hullabaloo. It's a different time.
Yeah. I would tell you. Obviously, I would tell you if it happened.
Would you?
Why wouldn't I?
Because we're all feeling like it did, and you're not telling us.
Something happened, and you're not cluing us in. Did you hang out with the ladies after that?
They watched you masturbate.
Did you Louis C.K. them?
Did they Louis C.K. you?
Did they Louis C.K. you?
Yeah.
Did you jerk off in front of them and go, Louis? That's called a Louis.
Did you sit him in a room and
jerk off in front of a girl and sing that song?
Did you jerk off in front of them and tell them an inappropriate Parkland shooting joke?
Yeah. Did you hang out with them outside of the shoot?
No.
Shut up, dude. One of them is the girl you're about to marry. One of them is the girl you're about to marry. Shut the fuck up right now.
Are
One
you
of them
marrying
is the girl
Danny Fox?
Danny.
It's finally legal in this town.
Corey, don't you understand that no love is more pure than a man and a man loving each other?
Lynn, you know Corey best. He's hiding something.
I don't think he's hiding anything.
You don't think he's hiding anything?
Hiding something, because how do they know that I worked on a porn? I think you're the only one.
He's looking for talking points about porn, so.
Oh. And the big Jacob.
So why are you striking out about everyone that knows you're trying to get us away?
Out. I'm on your side.
I just want to know how you guys knew that I worked on a porn.
I look at the rundown sheets. I just look at the rundown sheets.
Black Lou. Corey definitely dunked his dick, right? Did he dunk his dick? He definitely dunked his dick, didn't he? In something. In some hole. Maybe even a hand hole.
He might put the tip in a little bit. Then he got guilty after he put the tip in. He's like, no, I can't do this.
A little in the mouth?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you girls are being paid.
Definitely.
I've been there. I had a guy, dude, a buddy of mine brought two, like, you know, webcam hookery type girls to a show of mine in Florida.
Oh, yeah, I remember this story. Yeah.
And I said that, and I just kept making excuses. And I was like, give him the day off, man.
Come on.
This is like weird. It's too weird.
Yeah, it's the summer.
Even after the show, when I believe a part of them was like, oh, this will be kind of fun, I was still like, nah, but you were like told to come do it. It's weird to me. I don't like that at all. But not you, Corey. You just go for it. Getting your dick sucked by these two prostitutes.
I'll tell you, as someone that knows Jay, if you do have anything, give it up, or else he will paint the worst picture. He's going to paint a picture way worse than anything that you probably actually did.
No, I wouldn't do that. How bad is a picture? Is this guy got his dick sucked by two chicks off camera?
I like him as a sex crimes investigator.
Yeah,
SVU. Oh,
yeah,
call me Stabler,
dude. You could get in there quick.
Did you talk with them, with the girls?
No, of course. What would I say to them?
Did you have
lighting?
Any person?
Hey. Did you feel like you were lit well?
That was some nice acting.
Did you see all of her pussy lips and folds? Good job. Hey, how you doing? I lit it. I just want to know.
He goes, I'm looking for a lighting guy that can really highlight labia minoris. Hey, any old hack can get the majora.
He goes, majora is old shit. He goes, what are you going to try and get me? Some hood? I got some hood.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm looking for
the blossom.
Norris.
The blossom.
He goes, I want to see.
I'm looking for the petals of the rose.
I want to see the rose. I don't want to see the hood.
Do you believe the girls came for real?
Which time? With me or with each
other? Oh, there it is.
You know you fucked up, right? You know you fucked up, right?
Yeah.
Got me. Yeah. Not enough people get that Menace Society reference. You know you fucked up, right?
Wait, so did you have sex with one of them?
Oh, it was both of them, yeah.
Cool. Now you're just playing along. Now, I don't believe that. I mean, I believe it could happen. I just don't think that happened.
Corey's such a smooth motherfucker. I don't know. I really feel like it did happen, and I think he just told us.
Now I know how the false confessions happen, because I just felt like I want to make you guys happy and just confess to the crime.
Corey's
One-on-one.
Corey's a very handsome guy. I'll tell you, you know, I could tell when he came to the Village Underground, I could feel Sherrod alpha dogging him a bit.
Started barking?
Started, felt like Sherrod was barking a little
Sherrod
bit.
Sherrod started barking
just
at the
came
door?
Out just was, it, Sherrod was very nice. It wasn't nice at all, but it was just like, for somebody who was drawing the Corey and just kept like, you know, come on, you want to hang out? And like, don't be like that. And like, friendly. Very yeah. friendly, but you just tell when someone's just
was
like.
Was he the MC?
He was big personality. You don't even know who he was. Oh, that is.
True that alpha.
You're alpha dogging him now.
No. You're alpha.
Which
alpha.
One was that? Who was that?
He goes, don't know. I was thinking about the two ladies I banged off a porn set.
Oopsie doodles. Sherrod was wearing the vest. He didn't perform on the show that night. He was the guy hanging out with all the weed out front.
Corey, what happens after they rap? Like, how long was the scene and then what happens after?
Dude, I got the fuck out of there as soon as I possibly could.
Really?
After you came, you realized it was weird to be there, right? You just fucked these two underage prostitutes.
These girls definitely got here by some sort of shipping container.
They go, bring them out, and they're like fucking cuffed and like connected the chains together.
Come on. And then Mr. Fox is like, well, at least cut their wrist restrictions.
Mr. Fox, I hate to jump in. Hey, me, Corey from Lighting. I
can I fuck one of them? He goes, of course, Corey, su casa, mi casa. Mi casa, su casa.
Take them in el baño.
Yeah. Also, literally, don't go outside for 3 hours. I think we're being monitored by the FBI.
Do you not want to tell us because they had to kill them afterwards? Because you tainted the
meat?
I was
involved, yeah.
Recycle porn?
I have a question. Corey, you've thought some crazy dark Yakuza shit that you want to tell us about?
You start saying what you do. You do the monthly videos for the Gambino family. What are they like?
We have a lot of questions. What's that was your first and only porn?
Yeah, that was the only one.
So when you found out, you were like, fuck this, I'm out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Was it your lights? So you had to like.
No.
It wasn't
Thankfully,
your lights.
I wasn't bringing anything. I just showed up. They had a bunch of. Now I'm glad I wore gloves. Now that I know what.
Yeah. Why were they squirters?
Was. Yeah.
Yeah.
They were squirters.
Jizz everywhere.
Projectile?
I don't know where you draw the line between projectile and not. How far does it have
between to? Leaking and like a.
Okay. If there was an arc.
There was an arc for sure.
Yeah.
So, great. Yeah. So the evil Knievel jumped over the Snake River.
Yeah. Hell yeah. That's a Fonzie squirter. Cleared the fucking jump the sharks?
Yeah, jump the shark. You Fonzie sharked it? So immediately, right when you're like, fuck this, I'm gone. Do you guys need anything? And he's like, well, the office scene's just the first scene.
No, I got out of there immediately and thought I wasn't going to tell anyone about it. And then 10 years later, here I am. Talking
yeah.
About
it. So, Corey, I need you to light the helipad upstairs.
Hairy pussies. And don't give me any I don't remember bullshit.
No. Don't.
Bald. Both bald.
Shorn.
Huh. It's 09, no. Dude. It's a different.
Have you ever found the porn itself? Have you found it online?
How would I search for that?
I don't know. Office sluts 78, and then work your way down.
Like it's probably a lot of results.
Are you
down and or up?
Did you stunt cock in this thing? Is that what you don't want to tell us?
Yeah, you pop loads, don't you, dude? You're old reliable, Corey.
You think you're gonna find this thing and just see a clip of me?
Filming
the
in the mirror. You're in the mirror.
Yeah. Wait, pause right there. Look at the bounce back. That's our friend Corey, right by the door. I think he's leaving.
Oh yeah, look at his face. He definitely fucked one of these.
Yeah, that's got to be a rogue porn that they just filmed. And you
I
know.
Also had hair down to my shoulders at that point too.
Yeah.
Oh my God, you work in film and you had filmmaker hair.
Oh man, did you have a man bun when you were putting up the lights?
I never could grow that much hair. But,
oh, okay.
But yeah, it was weird.
Yeah.
He's like a film crew guy.
You ever seen Pearl Jam live?
Live.
Yeah, that's got to be a fucking weird thing to be just brought out of nowhere, where you're just lighting it, and all of a sudden you're like, oh, this seems like a weird, shitty movie, and then you're like, this is pornography.
You weren't offended, were you?
I wasn't. I'm more offended that I'm going to be involved in this video that's being
made
right now.
This is more offensive than two young ladies squirting for a living.
Sorry that woman wanted a raise at her job, and she's willing to do.
Do you believe it was real squirting, or did they pack them?
What's packing?
There was a syringe that was.
I think maybe they could put some like fluid inside. The girl can kind of fucking queef out.
Like when SNL throws up and they
yes,
put it on. They go,
yes. Well, there's a lot of. I mean, you know, there's tons of fake cum in porn.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a bummer.
It bums you out how much it is?
Well, especially when it's a poorly done one, and you can see like the fucking, it's squirting out of a fucking mayo packet below their dick from not their pee hole.
You know, I'm losing all my helmets.
Like, oh, and like shoots out of the side of the fucking dick. It doesn't make any sense at all. This was real, real squirting.
I think it was real. I didn't see any tubes or wires involved.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's a tube guy talking to Corey. He goes, did you know you were tubing up? I get called the tube up stuff in Midtown all the time. Did not know this.
He goes, yeah, this one surprised you too.
Usually I do parties, kids shit. He goes, this is kind of weird.
And you think as a guy who makes faux vagina squirt that I'd be more prepared for this when I walk in, but every time I am blown away that this is what they called me for.
Corey, Rob, I'm the tube king of Staten Island. Real quick, I'm not good with making
fake squirt king.
Yeah, he goes, I can make vaginal squirt all day. You need male cum? You got to go to my cousin, Ronnie. He's over in New Jersey.
What do they use for male cum, they say a lot? Like Cetaphil and water? Is that the best way to make cum? Yeah, Black Lou saying yes. He doesn't know. His uncle owns a fake cum factory.
Yeah.
If you get a golden ticket, you can get an actual tour of it. Should we take our second break and come back? Because we have someone who's also been on a porn set coming in the doors.
Yeah.
And maybe they'll recognize Corey. Corey, do you
think
that'd
be so weird? She comes in, she goes, were you there when I shot Danny Fox's Office Sluts 78?
She goes, I only remember the title because it was the shittiest lit movie I've ever been a part of.
I didn't know if I was sucking dick or eating puss. You know what I mean? That's how badly lit it was. I was in there just chomping and a swapping.
Corey, you're a fucking fantastic lighter. I mean, especially for two guys who hate light as me and Dan do.
We hate light.
You really make us look fantastic, and I appreciate that. You and Lynn always. And we'll throw you a couple nods when we have our guest in here. Let him know that you're also industry. Christine, did you just find your favorite squirting video?
Yeah. No, I just found a squirting video to go
out. Oh, sure, just
on.
A one, right? Yeah. Sure.
Oh, thumbnailed.
I did. I Googled.
Well, let's see. Take us home. Did it look like
that? Oh! That looked like a fucking water balloon. What up, old faithful?
Jacob, why are you making a face at that?
It's so messy.
Yeah.
Jacob, why are you making a face at that?
What? I'm in the different... It doesn't do anything for me.
I don't know if I'm into this particularly. I am.
Come on. Can you ask me that? You ever see Aliens?
Well, Mr.
When Bishop
Jacob,
gets his
turns
torso
out,
ripped off, that's what just came out of this woman.
What came out of this woman was some sort of a seminal fluid.
And it looks like Old Faithful was active again.
Jacob, what?
Let's take a break.
Why are you taking it out on me? Dan looks just as
I cringe
grossed
to,
out
I
as
cringe
I am.
To cool
I know
way.
What a Nancy Dan is, oh. But too, Jacob.
Our guest, you can catch a Gossip in Long Island this weekend, June 7th and 8th. Welcome back to the show, the legendary Lisa Ann.
You picked a good day, Lisa. It's Women Who Play Rock and Roll Heavy Metal Music Day.
Yep.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
According to Dan.
Okay, good to know. It's official?
That's how I said it.
It's a fish.
I said it just like that. Donut Day, all that good stuff?
Yep. Welcome back to the show.
Thank you for having me back on the show.
It's great to see you. We didn't even know this until today, but our camera guy, Corey, very active on porn sets.
Oh,
had
really?
No idea.
Yeah. Doing?
Midtown lighting.
Oh. I thought you were going to say fluffing.
No. He invented the wattage of light that can show labia minoris.
You just roll with whatever they say, right?
Yeah, most of the time.
Well, I mean, you know, we're like the Steve Jobs. We're the idea guys, and then Corey comes and makes it happen.
We give the big picture. He does all the tinkering.
I'm like, I want to see it.
Yeah.
What do you mean? The minoris. I want to see it. Yeah. Can you get me the wattage of light to make that happen?
We just found out that he got hired for a lighting job, didn't know it was a porn, came and lit it, and it was a porn.
Many people in the business, makeup artists, wardrobe stylists, will say to me their first job, they did not know it was porn until they got there.
Really? And then he showed up. Yeah.
He thought it was just a shitty movie with very thin dialogue.
That's literally what he thought. He was like, oh man, this dialogue.
It took one girl's nose and the other girl's asshole for him to realize what was happening. And that's the only thing I haven't made up so far that I've said to you.
That's the only thing that is true to life.
The only thing that I've said so far that is absolutely true is Corey said, until they were 69ing, wasn't quite sure what was going on.
Huh. All right, then.
Which is very bizarre. Which is maybe a testament to their acting.
or a testament to how dedicated he is to lighting and not being nosy on set.
He's just looking up. He's like, this lighting is so good. Oh my God, those women are eating each other.
Dude, if I was in a porn, you have to yell cut so much for you to see my stupid forehead like coming just in the top of the screen of my forehead.
Disappearing over. Cut! Cut! Hey, what the fuck is this guy doing?
What did I... Oh, did you get my hair in again?
He goes, Claude, he goes, Jim, I can't keep it hard with this guy keep peering in. Jay's like, hello.
He goes, and you just hear me go, oh, man, no way.
Have you ever been on a porn set and just seen someone be completely unprofessional like that?
Oh, my God. Of course.
You just being like, yeah,
a lot of times it's the creepy homeowners.
Really?
Oh, so, the person they're renting the place from. Right. I bet they, because they're like, well, it's my house. I'm
gonna. So, like, they'll hear, like, friends renting out their house. Oh, it's great money. You know, you should have some people over. And the next thing you know, like, he's, like, always forgetting something. He, like, comes back to the house, like, six, seven times.
It's so great.
And it's annoying because it's loud. And then sometimes you have to stop what you're doing because he's doing something in the kitchen. And you're like, dude, like, sound is an issue here.
Sorry, I'm blending up my kale and my ninja.
Yeah, it's so funny, the thought of a like guy. That. There's, like, a DP on a bed. And a guy comes in. He goes, forgot my keys. Just in the thing next. He goes, left these behind.
I'll tell you an idea that I thought was bad in porn that looks like it went bad one time. There's a video of it going shitty on some of those sites, like the renting out the frat house and doing a frat house porn. There's a video online. Have you seen that clip of like the guys are just being so shitty to the dudes? And what's just great is the dudes, because you know the porn dudes are pretty big, muscular dudes.
They're in shape.
And dude, them just stopping fucking and their boner like bouncing around. He's like, what the fuck, dude? You say something again, motherfucker. What's up? Like getting in his face, his dick. And they're like, there's like 80 of us, bro.
Just a
I don't
guy,
know what you think you're going to do.
It's just like, a guy in a collared shirt being talked down to. He's like, I don't know. Why? I'm sorry.
But they were.
Those houses are disgusting. But, Bang Bros does it in Miami. I did one once, and it was like six girls. They have the performers there, but then there's all the college students that get to kind of be in the room and watch. We all just walked in. We're like, somebody's going to Walmart. Yeah. Somebody's buying cleaning supplies.
No shit.
And somebody is cleaning this house before any of us take our clothes off. I mean, just disgusting.
But then the guys, I would assume, get drunk and act like assholes, though, Dorian.
Well, they're actually not supposed to if they're not of age. True. But yes, they do act like assholes the entire time.
Really?
Because yeah. they
I would never do that again.
And try to, like, they talk down to you and stuff
like that?
They're
just awful. Just did absolutely they, awful.
That video's
the whole time.
Nuts. You find the video online of the girl, and he sees the girl outside. It's actually the girl I always say I feel like you look like.
Whoa.
Ashley Blue.
Oh, yeah. I think
Ashley Blue is one of the outside going like, what the fuck was that? And they're like shell shocked. Like, what the fuck happened back there?
It's really not a good idea. If you think about being outnumbered, I mean, even with the crew and the talent, there's probably like 10 or 15 of us. There's like 70 of them. And I'm like, whose bright idea was this with no security? You know?
Oh, come, especially fucking 19-year-old guys that think they have something to prove.
When I used to drive strippers to bachelor parties and stuff, I was always surprised. Now, here's the thing. I get a buddy. If something's weird's going on with a girl and she's like, I get like the snicker to your buddy. I never understood the thing like, oh, God, her ass is awful. Like shit like that. So you're like, buddy, like it's such a weird, vulnerable spot to put somebody in.
Yeah.
And, to like shit on them, and it's
my roommate wouldn't sell weed to frat boys without me with them. I can't imagine, you know, going to like bag
assholes.
Yeah, they're just all they're dickheads.
Yeah,
they're young assholes.
Young,
too. They're not even like developed assholes.
And fraternities usually cost a lot of money to join and shit. So these guys are like usually rich young assholes, and they're just like
the rapists of America.
Yeah, and they're filming a porn in there, and they're just like, oh, well, that's my controller. And just like you're being dicks.
No, it's not even that. It's worse. I'm actually saying like, oh. Why don't your tits be the same size? Yeah. Like it's like they're shitty to the girl.
They should have given you guys
like they're watching
spray
it on TV
and just fucking.
But no, that was part of the element of this type of scenario was the interaction, right?
Yeah.
So they didn't tell the guys to stop being shitty to the talent or anything. They just wanted this banter.
You think they want to like woo-hoo and shit, but right? They start getting. Do you have that, Christine, at all?
They should do like MMA but at home, like MMA fights in frat houses, and then if the fucking guys get out, they just get pulled into an MMA. Oh God, he just fucking.
You guys fight like pussies.
Yeah. I think half the girls could beat their asses more than the guys.
Dad, just let them loose.
These girls have been in fights in strip clubs. Once you've been in a fight in a strip club, you're ready.
Yeah,
you
man. What,
you got to fight.
Because that's like fighting
World
in the dark.
Oh, yeah.
World Star Hip Hop's got
Batman
tons.
Shit.
World Star Hip Hop has so many great videos of just black strippers fighting in the fucking dressing room.
Their wigs go flying.
Yeah. I mean, wigs go flying. And somehow, those titties and pussy never come out. Whatever that little sliver of fabric that's covering their nips and pussy.
Stays on.
But they will stand there before they fight and snap all their nails off. And that just just
have you ever heard?
So painful,
have you ever heard
you know,
that?
Like they're acrylic nails, and to see them popping off, and I'm like, oh, shit's going down. I lock myself in my dressing room when these things happen.
That's cool.
And
so
I hide.
So it's fun. You're featuring.
I see it all the time when I'm featuring. I just kind of cup to the door listening. I mean, my first real ass beating was in a strip club.
Really?
Yeah. I was 17. I was at the Golden Slipper, which is
what'd
outside.
You do?
And I'll tell you, the design of this club is there's two stages and then there's a spiral staircase that goes up the dressing room. Okay. What I did was I danced for a girl's regular, but I didn't know. I was new to the club and I didn't know the game of the business yet. She didn't even discuss it with me. She's waiting at the top of the spiral staircase, keys in hand, and just beats the shit out of me. I was so afraid of this girl after that. Took myself to the hospital, got my tetanus shot.
So hold on real quick. You come up the spiral staircase.
She just blindsides
are you just in,
me.
Are you in just in
completely
like high
naked.
Just in high heels?
Yes.
And you just fucking boom, lights get rang.
Right. And when you're not expecting it and it just starts, you don't know where to get out of it.
That's most fights,
If you've ever been jumped, you know, you just don't know where to start to get out of it. So I just remember that feeling. And ironically, years later, I went back to feature at that club and I told the owner, do you mind if I take the other steps?
That's so funny.
I'm a little traumatized by the spiral staircase.
That girl didn't work there anymore?
No, she's probably dead.
So she didn't explain that you did something wrong?
No, hell no.
What about after? When you after?
Hell no. I just stayed away from her, never worked her shift, saw her car in the parking lot, would wait for it to leave, and then I'd go in and do my work. I wasn't playing with that bitch.
What was the next level of that? What is the actual rule that you broke there?
I took money, what she thought was hers, you know?
So it's just, but it's... If it's someone who's a regular, but is there a thing between the girls like you don't dance for someone else's regular?
Sure, but when you're new to a club and you haven't scoped out the territory, after that, I learned that when I started dancing at a club, I would scope it out for a week or two first before I started.
Sure.
Just to be like, okay, is this girl have a boyfriend and she's
but
lying?
Isn't that
and
the responsibility on? Isn't that the responsibility on the
club?
No, I mean like the regular, like if he wants to hire you, you have to say no if he wants to get a dance from you?
It wasn't dances. We weren't allowed to do dances back then. We just danced on stage back then.
Holy shit. So you got your ass beat for just dancing in front of a dude?
Just for taking tips from the guy.
That's crazy. That's like Singapore rules for chewing gum.
We used to get paid $25 an hour to be at a strip club, and then we would just go down on stage 15 minutes an hour, pick up our tips, and sit up in the dressing room and read until it was time to go back down. Like, there was no interaction.
I swear to you, I promise you, they weren't, no one, it was just only reading in between.
There were a lot of girls, believe me, as crazy as it sounds.
That's what they were having in the thing.
We had no chairs. We had no lockers. We had no nothing. Everyone sat on the floor and just would be in a book because everyone was really afraid of each other. A lot of the girls carried guns back then.
Chocolate strawberry?
Yes.
There's no strawberries at clubs back then. Or chocolate.
Excuse me? Yes. Oh, yes, let me... You take one of those, like, the cloth... cloth.
Literally read so you didn't get your ass beat.
With the reading glasses? Cheyenne, yes? I'm reading Dickens.
Tell him I'll be right there, pussy, wet.
But that is a thing of keep your head down so you don't get fucked up.
Oh, I was so afraid
that's
of the girls.
That's like prison mentality.
So afraid of the girls. I used to take my bag with a bike lock and lock it to the plumbing in the bathroom so nobody would fuck with my shit. It's much less.
And
rough
it's probably blows hot and cold though when you come in the feature dance too, because there's got to be girls being like, "Who's this bitch think she is?"
It's different because
I have my own space.
I have my own security with me, and hopefully I can bring more customers so they can make more money. That's the goal. Making them money.
It's
the
like
girls
a big
are pretty
weekend.
Cool to me now. You know what I mean? I'm not taking their money. I'm adding to their money.
Because you're drawing an audience.
And I don't really do dances, and I don't really take any money after that. I just want the girls to make more money so that they want me to come back.
When did that turn? When did you feel that turn where you knew that if you were feature dancing in a club, you were bringing more money in?
Palin. Definitely when I did Palin. The game changer for me.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. It was a total game changer. I remember we're doing this 50 weeks a year for the next 4 years. And I did. I did it 50 weeks a year for 4 years straight.
Fuck.
You with your stage show would be the Palin thing?
What a road dog.
Wanted to see.
It was, but the money, I remember I was in Michigan at a Deja Vu, and every single person in the club stood up and lined up for a photo. And I walked downstairs, and the whole border of the club was just people lined up. I'm like, yo, every one of these motherfuckers worth like $20. I'm loving this. Let's get more bookings.
It's so fun. We went to go meet when I was younger. I told you the other day, I think, didn't I, that we went to meet a porn star, Shane.
Oh, I remember Shane from Shane's World.
Shane's World.
Yeah. I remember Shane's World.
She was
so hot.
Yeah.
We did not look in person, looked emaciated. I think it was towards the end of her career or something, but she didn't look very good. But anyway, she came and did like a signing autograph picture session at a porn store near us, and my friends had all, we all had sort of like the, it'd be funny, let's all go to the thing. And everyone took a picture with her, and I still couldn't do it. The picture is you stand behind her, basically, and put your chin on her shoulder, and you, like, squeeze her tits, but I don't know. It just felt, I didn't do it. I took a picture, like, well, arm.
Yeah, I don't do the squeezing like arm of the tits. This is not a petting zoo.
It's just, that's exactly okay. How it felt. It's like, yeah. You're just like,
no.
Next, it's like
this
the
is
last,
a no-contact sport. We're standing side by side.
But, like, the last weird guy, like, fucking, you know, wearing, like, a fucking Japanimation t-shirt and 500 pounds just squeezing her tits, and then I'm behind him like, my turn, thank you, Mrs. Shane. Okay, that was awesome.
On I'm her like, ew.
I wasn't even grossed out by it, other than I was like, I don't want, it's always me, it's my own ego shot, I don't want her to view, I'm already picturing in my head what she's saying about all these guys coming up like, I love all your films, and then smiling with her you know, tits in their dumb hands, that I'm like, I don't want to be viewed, I don't want her to go home and have me as one of the pictures in her head of just like, cheese.
I felt like that.
Squeezing tits and like.
And we love guys like you because you're really just there for the moment. You're hanging with your friends. It's not a life or death situation. Like, if you didn't get the photo, it wouldn't even freak you out.
Yeah.
You
know, I couldn't say where the photo's at today.
This dude's waiting. It was probably on Polaroid back then.
It was
too,
a Polaroid.
Yeah. 100%.
And she signed the bottom, yeah.
Oh, fuck. Yeah.
You guys recognize Dan Soder?
Hi. How are you? Sesame Street. I did some work. I did some work in the live action Clifford the Big Red Dog.
Oh, we keep looking back. Are you guys wondering if this is Dan Soder?
The kids.
What's that?
Adults are like, why are these adults talking to my kids?
Yeah, right. Do you have a problem with
that? Oh, they clearly recognize you.
I go.
Billions heads. You can put this on TMZ if you want. We don't care.
Midtown Famous. Homeboy. These guys saw it. These guys saw it. Direct. This was the worst idea in the world.
I can't. But Dan wanted to go be around people in suits so they would say hi to him.
Fuck you. This is terrible. This is almost nightmarish, being stoned in the middle of a courtyard. What are you doing there?
Taking my.
What's up, dude? You selling pills?
What?
What do you got?
What are you doing? Kratom?
No.
You fucking taking K bombs?
You blasting off? What do you got?
Sniffing?
Aspirin.
What are you doing? Sniffing?
Let's go over here.
Why do you not want to be around people? Yeah, it's Dan Soder. You picked the right spot. Dan Soder.
I can't wait till you're on a cool business show.
Never going to happen.
Son of a bitch.
I'll be the same level of known from here.
No, you're right, though. It's just like that dude just... But they don't stare at me like they want to talk to me. They stare at me like they want to fight me.
Yeah. Well,
they really do. They look at you, they're like, why are you mad at me?
It's Dan Soder.
I hate you. I hate you so much. You're
crazy.
You're,
it's New York, though, right?
Oh, she has no idea what you're saying. That made me feel better, realizing you were talking a little bit of English.
I'll get somebody else.
No, don't. I'm going to go inside.
You young men wondering if this is Dan Soder? Because it is.
Guy Code. Guy Court.
What's up?
Dude, the second we go to a flea market, I'm yelling your name everywhere.
Hell yeah. They're going to know me so much. Yeah. Go to the bootleg VHS
Korn.
Guy.
I go, open for Korn. They're like, Jay, they're just cool though.
Jay, give me a bunch of bootleg VHSs. Yeah.
These guys just stare
flea
me
market.
Down. These guys just stare me down like, is that a real firm?
Oh, dude, take me to a rodeo. I'll high-five people all day.
Rodeo's my dog trying to cut into my Colorado ties.
No. No one thinks of you when they think of rodeo. They think of
no
finance.
No one thinks of you.
Finance.
Finance rodeos.
Rodeo, no, I entertain a lot of rodeo
people. This guy said it. He proved your point.
Dan Soder?
No, he doesn't know. They don't know my name. You say Mafee.
Mafee. Sorry. My apologies.
I gave him the bullets. I gave him the bullets. All right, I'm walking inside.
Why? No, no, no.
I don't like this.
They're so excited to see you, though.
Oh, you're ripping my mic.
What happened? Our mic. Finally, we became one.
See what happens with Jay's accessories? They hurt those he loves.
Let me clip it back on for
no,
you.
No, dude. I'm going inside. You can only get audio.
What are you, just are like you wondering what they're show. Filming for? It's Dan Soder.
God damn it. It's you, dude.
Someone else is going to notice.
I don't want to notice. I'm out. For that reason, I'm out.
No.
Shark Tank. What sucks is it's a fucking bar for finance people right there. And billions and right
you're right.
There.
We're not standing close enough to the bar for finance people.
I'll see you guys later. I'll see you guys. Now you just look like a crazy person waving. I'm hugged by the shrubs, dude.
Bet you I play the odds. They're going to know you.
Dude, no one knows. God damn it. All right. This has been a fun smoke break.
Ladies, you have a man who pays for showtime in your life?
They didn't know.
All right, really? The one time I want you to fucking be boisterous?
Sup? Ladies, they show billions at the volunteer firehouse?
Hey, when you're Narcanning people in Pontiacs, in Wawa parking lots, did you go and watch Billions? Oh, yeah.
Man, we really picked our marks, huh?
Yeah, why don't you say it to them? Why? You're racist. Why do the black guys look like
that? I didn't think those guys would know Billions.
Racist ass Jay, not saying it to black people.
Not black people with blue hair.
I'm going in.
Stan Soder.
I hate you. That's your last one.
From Billions.
Real, though.
On Showtime.
He's being a dick.
Why am I being a dick? Because you're on Showtime.
Oh, thank you.
Oh! Oh, am I being a dick? Yes, sir. Dan Soder, you, Billions, talking to the ladies. LL Cool Dan.
Come in. Yeah.
Dan Soder wants to talk to me?
You.
He said he wants to talk to me.
Didn't get enough Bonfire? Well, like, subscribe, follow, all that stuff at The Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat.
Or wherever you do computer stuff.
You know, all the computer places.